In this technical demonstration, we will show you how to configure PowerChute network shutdown to support a Dell VxRail cluster. We will then showcase PowerChute in action, protecting your VxRail system during a power outage. First, we will deploy the PowerChute appliance. Log into vCenter server, right-click on the cluster in the inventory and select Deploy OVF Template. Choose Local File, click Upload Files, and browse to the location where you downloaded the PowerChute OVA file. Click Next. Enter a name for the PowerChute virtual machine and click Next. Select the VxRail cluster as the compute resource and click Next. Click Next. Review and accept the license agreement and then click Next. Select the VxRail data store and click Next. Select VM network as the destination network and click Next. Customize template allows you to configure static IP address and network settings for the PowerChute VM. It is recommended to use the static IP address. Enter a root password. This is used to access the PowerChute VM via the VMware console or SSH. Enable SSH access if required. This is typically only needed to gather log files for troubleshooting. Set your preferred time zone. This determines the timestamp that will be used in the event log. Enter the username and password that will be used to access the PowerChute UI. This prevents unauthorized users from accessing the setup wizard after the appliance is powered on for the first time. Please note the password complexity requirements. If the password entered does not meet these requirements, the PowerChute service will be disabled for added security. Click Next. Click Finish to start the OVA deployment. Select the cluster, click Monitor, and select Tasks to view the deployment progress. When the deployment task completes, select the PowerChute VM and click the Power On button. Launch the web console to view the URL that is used to access the PowerChute Setup Wizard. We will now show you how to use the Setup Wizard to complete the configuration. In your preferred browser, enter the PowerChute URL. Enter the username and password that were set during the deployment. On the welcome screen, click Next. The Customer Experience Improvement Program helps us to improve our products and services by collecting anonymous usage and configuration data. Click Next to proceed. Select IPv4 and click Next. Choose Host Managed by vCenter Server and click Next. PowerChute requires a license to avail of advanced virtualization features and support, such as VxRail integration. If you do not have an internet connection, you can use the offline method to activate, otherwise choose online. You will have received your activation ID via email from your partner or via Schneider Exchange. Copy and enter your activation ID in the field provided. In the quantity field, enter the number of nodes in your VxRail cluster. In this case, we have 3 nodes in the cluster, so 3 licenses are needed. This is one activation ID with a quantity of 3. Click the Activate button. The PowerChute license has been successfully activated. Click Next to continue. Enter the details of the vCenter server that is managing your VxRail cluster. In this case, vCenter is deployed as a VM, so we enable this checkbox. Choose VxRail from the drop-down list. Click Next. PowerChute will attempt to connect to the vCenter server using HTTPS. For enhanced security, PowerChute presents the SSL certificate used by vCenter server. Verify and accept the certificate in order to proceed. PowerChute will not connect to any system over HTTPS unless the SSL certificates have been added to the PowerChute key store. Click Next after adding the SSL certificate. PowerChute supports a range of UPS configuration options. For this demo, we will choose the single UPS configuration. Enter your security details, the username and password are used to access the PowerChute UI. The authentication phrase is used in conjunction with the username to secure communications between PowerChute and the network management card in your UPS. Click Next. Enter the IP address of your network management card and click Next. Confirm the details and click Apply to register PowerChute with the network management card. The connection fails because the NMCs are using self-signed certificates and are therefore untrusted. Click the Fix Issues button. The Certificate Management screen allows you to view and verify the SSL certificate details for the NMC. Accept the certificate to add it to the PowerChute key store and then click Next. Click Next and apply settings to complete the registration process with the NMC. As part of the registration, PowerChute carries out a check to ensure that your network management card firmware supports VxRail integration. Click Next. Select all nodes in the VxRail cluster where PowerChute is deployed and click Next. On the Host Certificate Management screen, verify and add each of the vSphere Trusted Root CA certificates. Click Next. Enter the VxRail Manager IP address and click Next. Verify the VxRail Manager SSL certificate, add it to the key store, and click Next. If your UPS supports outlet groups, select the group providing power to the equipment and click Apply. Click Next. The Virtualization Settings page allows you to define the times needed for each step in the VxRail shutdown sequence. Click Next, confirm your settings, and then click Next to apply the changes. We recommend enabling the option to turn off the UPS after the VxRail cluster is gracefully shut down. This helps to preserve UPS battery life, rather than letting the battery drain each time there's an extended power outage. Click Next, and then click Finish to complete the setup wizard. We will now review the UI changes that have been added in PowerChute v5.0 to enhance usability. The UI now uses a horizontal tab menu to group features. Under Home, select View Events Log to pinpoint when issues occurred. The Configure Events page allows you to define which UPS events will trigger a shutdown sequence. For example, UPS on battery power for 2 minutes. The SSH Settings page allows you to configure SSH actions. These can be used to run commands on remote systems such as a storage array via SSH. You can configure multiple SSH actions and have them run during the shutdown or startup sequence. The virtualization settings page allows you to fine-tune your shutdown and startup durations. The host protection page shows which hosts in the inventory are protected by PowerChute. You can enable VM prioritization to configure the order that your user VMs are shut down and powered back on. Select VMs from the inventory on the left and add them to a priority group on the right. VMs in high priority groups are shut down last and powered on first. Then set appropriate durations for each priority group. We will now provide a brief overview of how PowerChute works in conjunction with the network management card to shut down a Dell VxRail system. When a UPS event occurs, PowerChute begins shutting down all user VMs. After the user VMs are powered off, PowerChute notifies the network management card that it is about to shut itself down. The network management card waits the configured duration to allow the PowerChute VM time to power off. It then sends a cluster shutdown command using the VxRail Management API. This gracefully shuts down the system VMs, cluster services, and the ESXi hosts. When the UPS event is resolved, the hosts are powered back on. PowerChute will then power on all the user VMs that it shut down. We will now showcase PowerChute in action, protecting your VxRail system when a power outage occurs. The UPS has been running on battery power for the configured duration. This triggers the shutdown sequence. PowerChute begins shutting down VMs per the assigned VM prioritization groups. The lowest priority VMs are shut down first. The highest priority VMs are shut down last. We can see the delay between shutting down each group of VMs. System VMs, such as VxRail Manager and vCenter Server, are left powered on. PowerChute then sends a request to the network management card to initiate VxRail cluster shutdown after the configured delay. PowerChute then shuts itself down. The PowerChute request is logged in the Network Management Card event log. At this point, all user VMs, including the PowerChute VM, are powered off. After the configured delay, the Network Management Card sends the Cluster Shutdown API request to the VxRail Manager. The request ID is noted in the event log. Here we can see tasks in progress, preparing the cluster for shutdown. The VxRail Manager VM is migrated to the first host in the cluster. The VxRail Manager and vCenter Server VMs are gracefully shut down. All VMs are now shut down. Each host is placed into maintenance mode and gracefully shut down. Switching over to Hydra, we can see the hosts are now powered off also. When AC power is restored, the hosts are powered back on via the system BIOS. VxRail handles powering on the vCenter server and VxRail Manager VMs. A scheduled task powers on the PowerChute VM after vCenter server comes back online. PowerChute then powers on all of the user VMs that were shut down per their priority groups, minimizing downtime. The VxRail cluster is now fully online and all VMs are up. This concludes our technical demonstration. For more information, please contact your Dell partner or visit apc.com/PCNS. Thank you.